It's a beautiful day in Hawaii, nay, a beautiful October. Second week of October, my. Yeah, before we know it, it's going to be Christmas pretty soon. Unreal. Oh, how you guys doing this morning? Hope you folks having a good, beautiful morning. Let's say good morning to y'all. What's up, Pastor Brian, Auntie Wanda, and everybody else who's on. Good morning, a little early this morning, yeah? Warming up. Was a little cold. You was cold this morning, right? I was feeling cold this morning. I was like, what? I woke up. I was, oh, where that chill came from? Haven't been so beautifully cold like that in a long time. You know, where you actually had to use blanket. Whew. Well, I hope you guys ready to worship this morning. I want to give praises to the Lord. Lord, thank you for the beautiful day for us. Nice, cool night. Waking us up early this morning and energized to worship you this morning, Lord. Yeah. All right. Let's begin our worship as we give the Lord all full attention this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Come into our presence, Lord. Have your way.
Lay my life down at your feet. You're the only one I need. Turn to you and you will always there. Troubled times, it's you I see. I put you first, that's all I need. A humble altar.
The life to live by faith and not by sight for you.
God. Oh, hallelujah. It's one way. It's the only way. And I'm glad we're on the right direction. That way. One way. That way. Not this way. Yeah, that way. Continue to worship you, Lord. Warm us up on this beautiful morning. We praise you, Lord, for the air we breathe, the sun that shines.
He came to live a perfect life. He came to be the living word, our life. He came to die so we'd be reconciled. He came to rise to show. That's why. she gave his everything. He came to live. He came to live. Live again in us. He came to be our conquering king and friend. He came to heal and show the lost ones his love. He came to go prepare a place for us. Oh, that's why we bow to him. That's why we sing. That's why we offer here everything. Oh, that's where we bow now and worship this king. 'Cause he gave
Sing with me and I'll say hallelujah.
Worship you because you gave you everything and set us free. Now we choose to just worship you. We surrender our hearts to you this morning, Lord. Come on in, have your way with us. Clean us up from within. Let us shine on the outside.
Giving you my heart and all that is within, I lay it all down for the sake of you, my King. I'm giving you my dreams, I'm laying down my rights, I'm giving up my pride for the promise of you. Sake of knowing you, for the glory of
And I surrender all to you, all to you. Oh, and I surrender all to you, all to you. Lord, we surrender to you this morning. We open our hearts wide open to you, Lord. Come on in. Have your way with us this morning, Lord. Cleanse us from within, from deep within, that we can receive your blessings this morning. Thank you, Jesus.
Will I surrender all to you, all to you? Oh, and I surrender. Giving you my heart and all that is within, I lay it all down for the sake of you, my King.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's give God the glory this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Let's go to the Lord in prayer as we pray. E puli ka ko, e hova hemolele ki a kua I ka hiko ia. I ka nani ka ihi ihi a me ka hana hana. Ke ho mai e ka e ke ho zana. Ke mililani a ho ho ako ni e mako ia oe. No laila, e aloha mai oe I ka poikawa. I a koko mai nei, e ho mai ka ia mako. A me ka mako maohana. A elana pu mai ko uhani he molele me mako I kuliki ai ka mako lave lave ana me kau I make make ai. No laila, e ho onani ia ai oi loko o ka inoa o ka makua ke keki a me ko uhani he molele. O Holy Jehovah, the God is filled with splendor, sacredness, and glory. We thank, praise, and glorify thee this morning. Therefore, have mercy upon us who are gathered together. Bless us in our work, Lord. Let your Holy Spirit abide with us, that we may be able to do thy work according to your will. Therefore, we praise thee in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And we all say, amen. Good morning, everybody. Happy, happy second Sunday of October. October already. The festivities is happening from this month on, right? Yeah, the end of this month, and then next month is what, Thanksgiving, followed by December, which is Christmas, into the new year, and whoo, before you know it, poof, 2021 is what we call history. Praise God that we're here together to share this history together. Go around and greet each other. Let us know where you're from. If this is your first time, welcome to Light and Life Ohana Church. We're together again.
just praising the Lord. We're together again in one accord. Something good is about to happen. Something good is in store. We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together again in one accord. Something good is about to happen. Something good is in store. We're together again, just praising the... What's up, cousin Nadine? We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together again in one accord. Come on, guys. Something good is about to happen. Something good is in store. We're together again, just praising the Lord. Something good. Something good is about to happen. Something good is in store. We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together again, just praising the Lord. All right, good morning. Yes, we're together again, and it seems like it's like faster and faster we see each other, yeah? The week go by so fast. Unbelievable. All righty. Hey, we got just an announcement. We'd like to let you know, Bible studies. We're at the last book of Galatians, and we're going to finish it this week for sure. Last week, we took a pause because majority of us couldn't be on. So I didn't want to be on there by myself. So I canceled Bible studies, and we're going to have Bible studies this Saturday. This Tuesday is the last book of Galatians, chapter 6. We're going to tackle chapter 6 this coming Tuesday. And awesome. If you want to join us, please, by all means, join us. Our ID, we're on Zoom. Room 337-083-9458. Tap into our room and we'll let you in. And even if you just want to just kick back and watch, you know, inquities. Is that, I said that right? Inquiative? What is that word? Inquisitive. Sorry. Incurative. Maybe that's something else. But if you're inquisitive or you want to check it out and you want to check into a find a Bible study that might interest you, come on in. By all means, come on in, check it out. You don't even have to show your face. If you know, like, you can mute yourself, don't show your face, and just sit there and listen in your own cubicle at home, on your sofa, on your bed. You don't need to even dress up. Yeah. All right. So join us every Tuesday. So I want to say mahalos to all of you who come on. Our church members, as well as I have my cousins in Las Vegas. And once in a while, I have my cousin on a big island popping. Depends on her internet service, you know how it goes. Anywho, join us for Bible studies. Hey, we want to say mahalo to those of you that continue to come out. And just to let you folks know, yesterday I put out the new Daily Bread, which takes on from November to, I believe, January. It's quarterly Daily Breads that we put out there at Ohana Holly. You can get them there. We still have a few of this last quarter. And I think I got two left, bro. I was surprised. Some people have been taking some of the old issues, which is pretty good still yet. You know, even though, so I keep them, and I don't want to waste it. You don't want to waste the Word of God, right? So if you want to check out if we have some back issues, we do have a few back issues. We also have um, we also have, along with the Daily Bread stuff, they offer some special pamphlets too. So this is one of them. I don't know if you can see it. Sorry. There. The other day I was strolling around Ohana Holly in my scooter and passing out some compassion, because I just felt like Jesus was telling me people need compassion. So I was passing on some of this. Hey, if any of you want this, let me know. Send me your address and I'll mail you one, for real. I'll mail you one of these, compassion. And then we also have another book. I got 200 or 300 of them. And we gave out about 100, and maybe I sent some to my sister. So, sister, you'll be receiving some of these new ones. It's the Book of Life or something. It's a little square one, something different that they sent us. And they sent me like 3 boxes of them. So, go check it out. We want to praise God. Yesterday I was sitting and just talking and I went around too and talking with like Tess there yesterday, and even like Rena when she came in, it was talking a lot about anxiety, you know, with this COVID, everybody, and this anxiety and getting your shot, not getting your shot, and no more place to go sit down and eat and all of that. And, huh? Oh, really? That's okay. And, you know, so it was good to just going around and just good to pass out these pamphlets to people. There's a lot of people in need. I got to come across this couple from California, Christian couple, Mexican. And they was hanging, talking with Tess, and ended up, you know, she, every time I'm there, she's talking to somebody. She always introducing me. Oh, this is the pastor from, you know, from the one of the booths over here and stuff. So it was a nice time talking with this couple, and even with them was talking about, you know, the shutdown and anxieties and all of that. We was talking about faith, especially it's about faith, you know, how much, you know, if we really Christians and we put our faith and trust in God, then we shouldn't have anxieties. We should overcome our anxieties by just doing God's work. So it was an awesome time being there, and if I encourage you guys, you get a chance to be in town by Reward area. Stop by Ward, stop by Ohana Holly Marketplace. Our booth, our ministry booth is booth 113. So if you go in, shoot to the left, look for the famous waffle dog, Casey Waffle Dog. Look for that big famous Casey Waffle Dog sign, and we're like right next to them. If you cannot find it, just ask Auntie Laverne. She'll let you know where our booth is. We're right behind the food court they have right in front of Waffle Dog, right behind the wall. That's us right there. Go check us out. Go check out Roy's there throughout the week. And I'm usually there every Saturdays. We do a fundraiser there so we can get so that we can do our ministry. But we also have like to say mahalo to a lot of people that have been donating Bibles, books, and stuff to us. So big, big mahalos. Also want to say mahalo to some of our kupunas down at Ohana Holly. They've been baking stuff for us. Warren and Bobby. Shirley, right? That's her name, Shirley, and stuff. And those, all of those people down there. Also want to say big, big mahalos to Serena. Always receiving our peanuts because we're not there on our Friday. And Shirley comes down, so she take care of our stuff until we come on Saturday morning. So thank you, Serena. All right. Praise the Lord. We're going to get into, we had a special that I wanted to share you. It was a beautiful song. That's, what is it called? Some broken. We can't connect. Gracefully broken. Yeah. You're not connecting to the, I'm so sorry, gang. But if you get a chance, look up Gracefully Broken, Tasha Combs, I think, on YouTube. Check it out. Beautiful. That was supposed to be our special for today. Hey, but speaking of YouTube, just to let you know also, too, right after our service, Roy uploads our
service to YouTube. So you can find it on YouTube, and you can also share it from YouTube. I put it on Facebook that you can copy and paste, or copy and you can, you know, you can text someone or whatever, and you can share it. So by all means, please do share it. The more you share it, the more we spread the word of the Lord, okay? Thank you.
Good morning, honey. How are you feeling?
Oh, that's good. All right. We're going to get into, I guess we kind of do that, so we'll get into a word for this morning. And our scripture reading for today is found in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. Am I going to give my Hawaiian a break this morning? Can I? Yeah, I'm going to give my Hawaiian a break. And I'm going to do my pidgin, which is just as bad. My pidgin is just as bad as my Hawaiian. So we're going to do our scripture reading in pidgin, and then I'll try to read it in English. Okay? All righty then? All right. And you know what? You can find it now. That's why I did it. You can find the pigeon book, the pigeon Bible, in your Bible app. I found it on my Bible app, so I could paste it, so I don't screw up the, you know, typos. So if you want to check it out, you can find the Bible app, the pigeon Bible in the Bible app, and it's under HWP. Yeah. Okay. Number one, for the Thessalonica people. Chapter 5, I'm going to read from verse 11 to 15. Verse 11. So then, give each other good kind words and help each other come more solid inside. Just like you guys stay doing already. Don't make me laugh, right? What they supposed to do? 12. Hey, brothers and sisters, we ask you guys for do something, yeah? The leader guys who work real hard for help you guys, show them respect. They teach you guys how you're supposed to live when you stay tight with the boss. Verse 13. Because they do that kind of work, I like you guys go show them all kind love and aloha. And make them like they're important guys for you. Go live together with aloha. Verse 14. Brothers and sisters, we beg you guys for do this. The guys who no like work, tell them they better work. The guys think they know nobody, give them good kind words. Kokura guys that know not strong inside, hang in there with everybody and no get hoo-hoo. Verse 15. Make sure nobody go bad kind stuff. Oh, sorry. Make sure nobody go do bad kind stuff to the other guy for pay on back. For the bad kind stuff, he won't do. But try every time for do good kind stuff to each other and to all the other good guys too. Whew. Got you that bugger. All right. Now let's try this in English. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 11 to 15. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing. Now we ask you, brothers and sisters, to acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Verse 13, hold them in the highest regard in love because of their work. Live in peace with each other. And we urge you, brothers and sisters, warn those who are idle and disruptive. Encourage the disheartened. Help the weak. Be patient with everyone. 15, make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong,
but always strive to do what is good for each other and for everyone else. Let us pray. Lord, I want to praise and thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for these words of wisdom, whether it be in pidgin, whether it be in English, but it's just the same words, and it's just words of wisdom. And I want to thank you for this scripture that we are looking into this morning, and that you open our hearts and our minds and our ears to receive every little bit that you have for us. And we all might receive it in a different way, but it's this message today is made perfect for each and every one of us. So, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for waking us up to receive your blessing this morning. We thank you for the worship this morning. And we thank you for the hearts that are here to receive you, Lord. And, Lord, that may my words be your words and my thoughts be your words, that we can receive this, soak it deep into our hearts, but follow through by sharing the blessings you're giving us this morning with those that we meet, anyone that you put in front of us. And let us always be aware that you're doing something in our lives. We're not doing nothing. We're just waiting on you. But you put people and things in our lives that we can react to. So, Lord, I ask that you give us the current, the strength, and the positiveness to do all that you have already seen for us to do, Lord. Let us be humble, faithful servants, sharing the gospel with everyone. We pray this in your precious holy name. Amen. Well, when playing basketball with her girlfriends, Amber realized her community could benefit from an all-female league. So she started a nonprofit organization to foster teamwork and impact the next generation. The leaders of Ladies Who Hoop strive to build confidence and character in the women and girls and encourage them to become meaningful contributors to their local communities. One of the original players who now mentors other girls said, there is so much camaraderie among us. This is something I'd been missing. We support each other in so many different ways. I love seeing the girls succeed and grow. Well, God intends his people to team up to help each other as well. The Apostle Paul urged the Thessalonians to encourage one another and build each other up. He says that in verse 11. And God has put us into the family of his people for support in our lives. We need each other to keep walking the path of life in Christ. Sometimes that may mean listening to someone who's struggling, providing for a particular need, or speaking a few words of encouragement. We can celebrate successes. We can celebrate successes, offer a prayer for strength in a difficulty, or challenge each other to grow in faith. And in everything, we can always strive to do what is good for each other. What commodity we can enjoy as we team up with other believers in Jesus to keep trusting God together. Well, this morning we are looking into what the Word of God is teaching us to build the body of Christ with these four things: encouraging others, appreciating them, helping them, and forgiving them. In our first verse, in verse 11, as we talk about encouraging others, it says, therefore, right out of the Bible, it says, therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing. And I want to define the word encouragement, because that's the big word we're using right now. So if in your scripture, you can underline that word, encouragement. And encouragement in a dictionary, it says to inspire with courage, spirit, or hope. Giving courage or confidence of success. To support, uplift, and cheer on. You know, let me give you a little illustration. And I remember this, you know, when I was reading about encouragement and reading about just the definitions. Picture yourself as you near the end of a long race and your legs start to ache, your throat burns, and your whole body cries out for you to stop. Well, this is when friends and fans are most valuable. Their encouragement helps you to push through the pain to the finish line. And you know, this kind of took heart to me because I remember when my wife did the half marathon, yani. And you know, I could follow her on top of they had that tracking that I can see where she at and all of that. And then just about towards the end, and she was like in such crucial pain. And I know she's not the only one. I know there's a lot of people. And so, what was that? The last mile, yeah? Even the last mile or less than a mile, she called and I was talking to her. You know, she got the earbuds and I'm talking to her on the phone. And I was just encouraging her because she just wanted to. She was like her ankles and everything was starting to turn like jelly. And she was about to just collapse. And so, talking to me and me cheering her on and saying, "You got this, honey. You got this right there." I was like, "Look at the prize. What was the prize? Malasadas, yeah? Malasadas and banana or something like that, the end prize." And I felt so bad, you know, because when she got to the end, she made it all the way. You know, despite she was about ready to drop like about a half a mile even. Was just so much crucial pain, like literally like crying to me on the phone, and she was about to drop, but she made it because it was encouraging her. And that's the thing with Portuguese, you just dangle and malasada in front of them, and they continue to go, right? And when she got to the end, I felt bad because when she went to go get her malasada, it was all gone already. I was like, "Oh, honey." Yeah, because she was kind of like at the end, and people was already packing up stuff, but they ran out of malasadas and stuff. But I think you had one banana, yeah? But, you know, so I just told her, "Hey, go to right there. Land. It's right down the road," because it was at Kapilani Park, yeah? The end. So she went to get 1,000 malasadas. But, you know, that's the thing about encouragement. That's how important encouragement is. And that's what we do as Christians. In the same way, Christians are to encourage one another. Right? That's what he says. He says, therefore, he's telling to the Thessalonians, Paul. And that's like God telling us. Therefore, encourage one another and build them up. Yeah? Just as in fact you are doing. And you know, a lot of times, and I see this a lot of times, as Christians, in church, a lot of times, I've seen this so much on the worship team. A lot of times, instead of encouraging others, man, we're shooting them down. They do that so much in ministry. They do that so much in this world as Christians when we go around in our business. How many of us in business, we encourage others? Well, how many of us tell the truth? You know, even like musicians, yeah? You know, when you go to kind of like you go to do jobs where a couple of bands go up on the stage and all that, everybody, we critiquing the band up there, right? Oh my God, these guys not can even sing. Oh my God, somebody give him a tuna. His guitar is so flat, right? And we're not being encouraging, we're just criticizing. And that's what happens in a church, same thing. That's what happened within Christians itself. Oh, who's this guy? What, you think he good and all that in a bag of chips, boy? That's a human factor. And Paul is telling us this morning that, hey, cut it out. Even like with this, you look at the news and you go on social media and everybody's blasting all the guys come out, whether it's the governor, the mayor, the doctors. This guy's not even doctors. We think we know more than the doctors. Yeah, we shooting the door. This guy don't know nothing. Yeah? And that's what God is saying. They cut it out. Our job is not to criticize, but to what? Encourage. If we are to walk like Jesus, did Jesus cut them all down? No. He always, wherever he went, he encouraged. And the funny thing about encouraging from cutting down is that people, when they look at you, and if you, they don't even know you, but they can tell. I can tell you this for a fact. People can tell. I met people I didn't even know, but they heard of me. And I'm so glad that was a good thing, not a bad thing. You know, the first thing they say, oh, I heard, oh, you're the kind. And they go, oh, by what you heard, right? And the thing is that is being encouraging draws people to you. And that's what Jesus wants. And that's what we should be as Christians, is to draw not people to us, but when they come to us, that's when we can share God. That's when we can share the gospel. Yeah, because they know, oh, this guy is the kind. And we should be always be positive, because you don't know who's looking. Especially nowadays, everybody on, man, you don't even know, but you're on the camera, right? They're posting you. Look at this guy. He's a Karen. Everybody's pointing it. Yeah, let me share you a scripture, Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. It says, do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building. Let me say that again. But only what is helpful for building others up according to, and underline this, according to their needs, not your needs, according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. This is a great scripture. Building up the body of Christ, it's a team thing. Yeah? It's a team thing. We need everyone on the same page. It's not an I thing. And even though we live in this world of I, iPhone, iPad, IDs, iAndroids, it's an I thing. Selfies. God is telling us it is not an I thing. It's a team thing. It's a building of the body of Christ. One mind, one body, because we serve one God. And there's no I in the word team. Yeah? T-E-A-M. There's no I. So it's not an I thing. It's a team thing. It's a building of togetherness. And we're here to serve according to not I benefits or my benefits, but according to the needs of others. And as we do that, that's what I like this verse, yeah? When it says building up others according to their needs. And as we do that, yeah, as we pour into others and do stuff with their needs, it's your actions that's being seen and heard. When you see that next part, it says that it may benefit those. See, you're serving and helping someone, but it's also benefiting somebody else who's watching you do it. When you lift others up, you're also benefiting not just the person you're lifting up. You're benefiting those who are watching you lift that person up, helping that person's needs. And that's what God calls us to do, to be of one mind, because it's, we serve as one body. You know, in a church, it's a body of Christ. In a body of Christ, there's not one limb on this side, one limb that side, one. No, it all works together. It all forms together to serve as one body of one Christ. And when the body works together as one, the body can function, right? When your body, when your mind let go one way and your legs let go another way, does your body function? No, your body is torn. You don't know which way to go. You start getting wobbly, right? Let me share your scriptures in Philippians chapter 2, verse 1 to 4. It says, therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded. Having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind. Verse 3. Do not do nothing out of selfish, there's that selfie word again. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourself. Underline that, above yourself. Value others above yourself. Not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of others. We see scriptures that just pours out that God, that's what God calls us to do. God calls us to encourage others, to bless others, to help the needs of others that will benefit not you, will benefit others. Your benefit comes in heaven, where God says, great is your reward in heaven. God says, humbly do this for me, because great is your reward in heaven. But a lot of times we like our reward now. Yeah? And that's when you start doing things, what? For selfie. So number one is encouraging. Let's move on to our next verse. Verses 12 and 13. Now we're going to talk about appreciating others. It says, now we ask you, brothers and sisters, to acknowledge those who work hard among you, who care for you in the Lord, and who admonish you. And in verse 10, it says, hold them in the highest regard, in love because of their work. Live in peace with each other. Honoring Christian leaders, pastors. That's what he's saying. Have appreciation. And you know what? I believe it's I think pastors and leaders appreciation day coming up. And I was just tripping out because, wow, because I saw that on somewhere talking about that. And then in our message today that came out, that in the message that I was reading, that is a lot of times honoring Christian leaders. Sometimes we don't honor them in certain ways, and we don't thank them. Yeah, honoring the leaders, or your pastors, your elders, your deacons, your teachers, Sunday school teachers, anyone who's serving. Anyone who is called to serve, missionaries, you know, honoring what they do, you know, how can we honor them? Well, we can express our appreciation by letting them know how much that they help you personally in your life. Yeah, if this particular Bible school teacher had helped you in your life, hey, let them know. Thank them. Thank them for their ministry. Thank them for what they do or what they bring, what they say. Thank them for what they bring to the table. Yeah? For what they do to help others that you see. You see them blessing. Hey, bless them. Say, thank you so much. Yeah? Show your aloha. Yeah? Why? Aloha kia kua, because God is love. And God calls us to share that love with others. So why not? Sometimes we share the love of God, we forget that we also should share the appreciation and share our love with those who serve. We need to pray for them too. That's another way we can honor them, by praying for them. Yeah. We see a lot of pastors, leaders, missionaries that struggle in their ministry. And sometimes praying for them is a great way of honoring. Pray for their needs. Yeah. Pray for their continued strength and guidance. Yeah. And also, this is one very I think is a very good one, is to pray for their protection over the devil and any spiritual warfare. Let me share with you a scripture in Hebrews. Hebrews 13, 17. It says, have confidence in your leaders and submit to their authority, because they keep watch over you as those who must give an account. Yeah. Do this so that their work will be a joy, not a burden. For that would be of no benefit to you. Yeah. And I love this verse, because sometimes, you know, you hear like some of the members in a church or you know, that's where division comes in. And, you know, Paul seen so much of that with the Corinthians, right? When Paul left, that's when he had division. Because why? Because the congregation, they wasn't appreciating their leaders in the church. Yeah? They never had confidence in their leaders. Yeah? So they started what? They didn't submit to authority. They started looking for others. And that's what caused division. And why is that? It could be anything from whereas the leaders down to the members of self. Oh, I don't like this guy's preaching. It doesn't say anything to me. Right? Instead of looking into the words, we're looking into the guy. Oh, the guy no can talk. Yeah? You came today not to listen. You know, a lot of guys go, oh, I like when this guy preaching. Oh, a lot of guy preach. Oh, I'm going to turn the station, look at another preacher. Yeah? It's good, but sometimes you got to look between what God is really calling to that person. And then sometimes the honoring system is like talking to the pastor, saying, hey, you know, pastor, I never get what you were saying. Can you like explain that? Sometimes the pastor needs to know it's not reaching. The message is not reaching. Yeah? Because sometimes the pastor's fall through, he gets stuck in his realm. And he's not paying attention to maybe the Lord and what the Lord is showing him in his congregation. Yeah? If we say nothing, how would they know where they stand? Remember, they need and deserve your support, your love. Yeah? They cannot help your growth if you are silent. Right? Knowledge is power. If you don't say something, how can they know? Yeah? You know, man, I'm so crazy out of it. Like, I was talking yesterday. I said, yeah, my mind is kind of warped. I think that way. But it's kind of that's how I can see. Maybe everybody can see differently. But my thing was like, put up or shut up kind of a thing. Yeah, people always grumble, but they don't say nothing. Nothing to contribute. And they don't contribute positiveness. All they do is contribute what? They don't encourage. They just tear people down. And God says you need to share it encouragingly. And even with this, even if the leader is not speaking well, then encourage it. Share it encouragingly. Let them know, hey, pastor, I never get what you said. I kind of got lost here. Where you went over here? I had you at one point, and then I lost you. Yeah? And that helps the pastor. And if you, most pastors would take that as good criticism and helps us, encourage us to get back on the kind. Hey, we slack in some place. We better get back on it. Why? Because maybe we just was spread too thin. When we should be focusing on what God is focusing us on, was too busy taking care of something else. Yeah, so first of all is encouraging them. Second is appreciate them. Now, in verse 14, we're going to talk about helping others. In verse 14, it says, and we urge you, brothers and sisters,
Warn those who are idle and disruptive. Encourage the disheartened. Help the weak. Be patient with everyone. Be a team player. Don't get caught just sitting on the bleachers, as they like to say. Most of us, they like to show up at church. That's it. Yeah. That's it. When they call for volunteers, I was at a church, you know, get so much to do, and we're always asking for people for sign up or volunteer. Everybody too busy. Oh, let me just give you, I write one check to you. Da da da. You cannot buy your way into heaven. And sometimes that's how we are. Oh, Pastor, I'm too busy. But you know what? Yeah, I could give you $100 for God to take care of ministry. The $100 not going to help carry everything into the, not going to help carry all the equipment into the church. You know, we're in mobile church. The $100 not enough for me to go pay for guys for come and help carry the sound system so the worship team can sing. Because, you know, our worship team, they all, they need help with the heavy stuff. Yeah? And sometimes that's what God's telling us. We need to be available to serve. Be a team player. Get off of the bleachers. Some of us, we only like come church to receive, 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 receive. Yeah? Get off the bench and get on the field. Yeah? Get off the bench, get on the field. You know, if you had one, this is like when if you had one big sponge, and every time when you like receive, that's like pouring water on the sponge. The sponge is soaking up, soaking up, soaking up. So what? So much, the thing cannot soak up anymore. That's the same thing, like when you want to come to church and just receive, receive, receive. You're running out of space. Your hard drive is overwhelmed. So you're receiving all of this, and it's going nowhere. What you got to do to receive more? You got to take that sponge and what? Wring it out. Squeeze on all the water. Then you can go and receive more water. This is the idea of where God blesses you. You take his blessings and share it with others. The more you pour blessings out into others, the more Jesus will pour into you. The more God pours into us, the more we should be pouring into others. The more God shares with you, take it and share it with others. The blessings you receive today, share with others. That's how we grow as Christians and become like Jesus. If we just sit and hear the word, that's just 50%. If you come to church and just hear the word, that's just 50%. What is 50%? If in the grade? What is 50% in your grade, honey? On a grade level. It's like an F. Huh? A is what? 90% up? B is 80% up? C is 7% up? D is 50% up? Okay, that's a D. Almost like an F. Is that a good grade? No, the other 50% comes when you get off the bench, get off the bleachers, and get on the field. What does that mean, get on the field? That means when you get off your okole and start doing something, that's when you start sharing what you've been receiving all this time. Because when you start sharing it, that's where you're going to get the other 50%. That's when you're going to learn more about giving, about sharing, about patience, about loving, caring, uplifting, you name it. That's what you learn. You cannot learn all that sitting on a bench. Yeah? You cannot learn that sitting on a bench. You can read a whole lot about football.
how to throw the perfect spiral, or how to hit the perfect hit, how to perfect block and all that. You can learn all of that. But that's not going to help you nothing if you're still sitting on a bench, right? You're not going to learn nothing. Because when you get on the field, like in anything, you can learn how to fix a car. Or you can learn how to play music. When you get into the music field and you get out there and start gigging, it's a whole new world. I know a lot of guys, they like be cooks. I get a couple of friends. They went to Leeward, the culinary cooking, whatever. And then they got into the field and then you know what? They hated it. They hated it. Yeah? Maybe you get one child, went into the kind, got one degree, got into the field, they hated it. Changed the career. Changed the career. And that's the same thing with us. Because what? Unless you get into the field and learn it, like an on-the-job, you know, before, they never worried about degrees. They just went on-the-job training. Because when on-the-job training, that's when you're learning both sides. You're learning both sides. You're learning the book work as well as the hands-on. And that's the thing with church. You can learn the Bible, but you need the hands-on experience. That's when it all gels together. Let me share with you a scripture in John. John chapter 12, verse 26. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, my servant will also be. Yeah? The servant, Jesus saying, the servant, the disciples, they all became like him. Because why? They followed him. They did whatever he did. They never sit back on a bench and just read about it. He says, my Father will honor the ones who serves me. See, getting off the bench and on the field is the hardest part of that. What is the hardest part of that? Taking the first step. Taking the first step. That's the hardest part. Yeah? But praise God, because remember, you're not alone. Others are there to help you along the way. That's what other people, that's what the body of Christ is for, to help encourage you. Help encourage you to do and push you, so to speak, in the direction that the gifts that God has given you, and not just sit on a bench with the gifts and do nothing. Also, that God is always there along with others. God is always there, and he'll never let us down. He will never give you more than you can handle. God puts things in our life, and a lot of times we shoot them down before we even try. Right? God putting you this in life. Oh, Jeff, I like you be one pastor. And I was like that. I was like, what? Remember me? I was the biggest Jonah. All right, turn out of the way, run out of the way. But it's not what we want to do for the Lord. It's what God has called us to do. And the key to any ministry is just submitting. Submitting to what God has called us to do. And sometimes it's not what you think you're qualified for. I never felt or thought I was even qualified to be a pastor. At the most, I was thinking, oh, okay, wait. Maybe I'll go to school a couple times and I can be one worship pastor. Because worship was my thing. Music. I was raised more with music rather than reading scriptures. I couldn't even be, when I was young, couldn't even remember Bible verses, let alone the books of the Bible. Yeah? And sometimes we just shoot ourselves down. We shoot our own selves down. We're our worst enemy. And God has called us to do. God has called us to serve. And what God has called us to do, as we encourage and appreciate people, we are called to help others. We are called to help others. God has called us to help. God has called you. What is our purpose-driven life? That's what we need to figure out. What has God called you to do? And all things are done for his glory.
for the benefit of his work and the benefit of others. Putting others before self. Let me share with you one more scripture before we move into our last segment. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6. He says, humble yourselves therefore unto God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. God has called you to do something. And all he's asking us, he's asking us to do to get off of the bench is to what? Humble yourselves, therefore. Humble yourself and take that first step. Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand. Why? When you take that first step, he will lift you up in due time. He will bring you up. He will grow. You will grow when you take that first step. You're never going to grow. You're never going to learn how to run unless you start walking. Right? If you look at little children, they crawl. And that's what we do as Christians when we first start. Some of us, we cannot even crawl yet. Yeah. And then when we grow and you get bigger and more experienced, you start to crawl or drag yourself. Then you start getting on your knees. You start crawling. After that, you come to the chair. You pick yourself up. You're standing. Wow, you're standing now. Yeah. And then sometimes the helpers come along. Yeah. The helpers come along. Your parents buy you a walker, put you inside there, and you start going all over the place. So your legs start learning how to walk. And then next thing you know, take them off. You're still on the floor. You put yourself up. You start walking already. Yeah? By the time you reach, 2 or 3, the parents got to chase you down because we're running. That's the growth of any Christian. Same thing. But you got to take that first step. And we're called to help others to take that first step. It's a cycle. It's a cycle. Jesus came, taught the disciples. The disciples taught others, taught the pastors. The Bible teaches all that. It's a history thing. And now as pastors, as leaders, they teach the congregation to do the same. And that's what we taught. And that's what we're called to do because God said to the disciples, what? I'm going back to my father now. You know the work. He says, carry on. Continue to spread the gospel to the ends of the world. That's what we're called to do. Yeah? He tells us not to seek vengeance right there. Don't pay back wrong for wrong. Somebody wrong you, don't wrong them. What does he say? To bless them. What? Why are you going to bless this guy? He did me wrong. God said to. Are you kidding me? Yeah, God said to bless them. Why? Because great is your reward in heaven. The first will be last. The last going to be first. Let me share you a scripture in Romans 12, verse 19. Jesus says, do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath. See, revenge is not yours. He says, for it is written, it's mine to avenge. I will repay. I will repay, says the Lord. See, revenge is not yours. A lot of times we think revenge is ours. No. It's right there in the Bible. If somebody tell what you mean, you can read Romans 12, 19. Jesus telling us, don't take revenge. You know, like people around you, don't take revenge. Forgive them. That's what he says. Forgive them. Forgive others for any wrong they do to you. Yeah? Simple. Why? Because the devil wants you to repay, wants revenge. That's the devil. And a lot of times we're going to get into this stuff, and I tell you, you're going to get into this stuff. The more you become like Jesus, the more you're going to be hit with people trying to do you wrong. All you got to do, he said, God said it's simple. Forgive them. Revenge is mine. Don't worry. I get them. You just love them. Bless them. Forgive them. Because great is the reward in heaven. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. I got to say that again.
do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Instead of looking at opportunities to pay back offenders, we need to look for opportunities to forgive and bless them. Paul instructs us to forgive each other as the Lord forgave us, although we both offend Jesus. Yeah? But he died for our sins. He forgave us, and he gave us everlasting life. When we fall by taking revenge, or when we feel like taking revenge, when we feel like taking revenge, we should reflect on God's grace. Yeah? Somebody wronged you. You know, somebody went and hit you. You like turn around, crack them. Before you crack them, reflect. That's why that bracelet is very, very good. WWJD. Reflect. What would Jesus do? Would Jesus turn around and crack the guy back? No. He said what? Forgive and bless those that do you wrong. For great is your reward in heaven. Revenge is mine, said the Lord, not yours. And despite of all these offenses, we still commit to doing God's work. Let me share with you one last scripture in Colossians. Colossians chapter 3, verse 12 to 14. It says, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. He said, bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has any grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. Verse 14, and over all these virtues, put on love. Why? Because love binds them all together in perfect unity. God is love. It's as simple as that. God is love. Our message this morning is such an uplifting one. The Lord calls us all together to get off the bleachers and get on the field, get on the team. The only way we can build a strong body of Christ is to be of one mind, one heart, and one soul, serving one God. It is through faith and trust in him that we are called to do his will. And as we submit to his call, sometimes that may mean listening to someone who's struggling. Sometimes it means providing for a particular need. Or sometimes might be speaking a few words of encouragement. We can celebrate success by offering a prayer for strength in a difficulty or challenging each other to grow in faith. And in everything, we can always strive to do what is good for each other. What commodities can you enjoy as we team up with other believers in Jesus to keep trusting God together? By being encouraging to others, by appreciating them, helping them, and forgiving them. Well, let me share with you this story to end my message. And I'm not even sure of the title of this story, let alone the author of this story. But it goes like this. And some names have probably been changed to protect the innocent. Well, a man was driving his car when he saw an old tutu wahine stranded on the side of the road. And he saw that she needed help. So he stopped his Pinto near her Mercedes and got out. He smiled while approaching her. Still, she was worried, as nobody had stopped for hours. Moreover, he did look ragged and not safe, and his appearance was so poor and shabby. He could see how frightened she was, so he tried to calm her. "I'm here to help you. Don't worry. My name is Danny Kanakanui." The tire was flat, so he had to crawl under the car. While changing the tire, he got dirty and his hands were hurt. When the job was done, she asked, How much do I owe you for helping me?" And Danny smiled and he said, "Well, if you really want to pay me back, the next time you see someone who needs help, give that person the needed assistance and think of me." That same evening, Tutu Lady stopped by a small cafe. That place looked dingy. Then she saw a waitress nearly 8 months pregnant wiping her wet hair with a towel, and the waitress had a sweet, friendly smile. Although she had spent the whole day on her feet, Tutu Lady wondered how someone who has so little can be so kind and giving to a stranger. Then she remembered Danny. Well, Tutu Lady had finished her meal and paid with a $100 bill. Well, the waitress went to get her change, and when she came back, the lady was gone. She left a note on the napkin, and it said, "You don't owe me anything. Somebody once helped me, just like now I'm helping you. If you really want to pay me back, do not let this chain of love end with you." The waitress found four more $100 bills under the napkin. Well, that night, the waitress came home early. She was thinking about the lady and the money she had left. She was wondering how the lady could know how much she and her husband needed it, especially now when the baby will arrive soon. She knew that her husband worried about that, so she was glad to tell him the good news. Then she kissed him and whispered, "Now everything will be all right. I love you, Danny Kanakanui." Let us pray. Lord, I pray and I thank you so much for this beautiful message that you had given us, for this scripture that you had given us and shared with us this morning, Lord. Thank you for the blessing of the learning, of getting us to take that first step off of the bench and onto the field, to encourage us and knowing that it's not a bad thing to take that first step into doing what we are called us to do, Lord. And we know that you would not give us more than we can handle. And we know that you will send others to help us along the way to get where you want us to be. But Lord, we just want to praise and give you all the glory for allowing us to be team players and not leaving us stuck on the bench, but getting us on the field. And we thank you for always encouraging us to do so.
always sending people to encourage us and lift us up and help us reach the finish line. Despite all of the pain and suffering and the wobbliness in our knees and our ankles and our feet and the tiredness and the crushing of trying to reach the end, you always send somebody to help cheer us along and help us to get to that finish line. Even though you got to dangle and malasadas in front of us, but we pursue because we humbly live our life for you. And we eagerly serve you, not for anything other than your promise of letting us know that what great is our reward in heaven. That's what we seek for. We don't care about what's here, but our eyes are focused on what's above. So, Lord, you called us to serve others, put others before self. Help us to be humble servants, always putting others before self. Just as you did when you gave yourself to pay the price for all of our sins. Freely, your grace, you give us that we can have that great reward in heaven. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the hearts that are here to receive you, the Lord. And Lord, may I ask, and I pray that as they receive these blessings, that they go out and pour it into others. We pray all these things in your precious and your holy name. And we all say, amen.
Now I'm planted here by the water's edge.
Praise the Lord, gang. Thank you guys for joining us this morning. Hey, just want to let you know, if you guys have any prayer requests, please do me a favor, write it down, leave it on the comments. I'll get to it. Also, if not, you want to keep it private, you can either IM me or text message me. Or you can even email me if you want. Just leave it on the comments, and we'd love to pray for you. We also wanted to pray for, what is that guy's name? The manager at the Ohana? Raymond. If you can do us a favor, one of our managers at Ohana Holly, want to pray for Raymond, and also want to pray for Tess from Tess Kitchen. They could use our prayers, because if you can do us a favor, pray for them. And there's more people on the kind I forgot, but I just wanted to pray for them. They came to my mind right now. We can pray for Raymond and also for Tess, if you can pray for them. They really need our prayers. Who?
Uncle Norman?
Oh, your uncle? And also, if you can pray for Shelly's uncle, Uncle Norman from Hilo, pray for him. But if you have any more requests, keep them in mind. And let's go to the Lord right now. Just a short little prayer before we announce service. Lord, I want to pray for just your healing power, Lord. And we come with some petitions, Lord. If you can pray for Uncle Norman and help him with whatever he's dealing with. Also, we can pray for Tess that whatever procedures he needs to go through, Lord, we know that your will be done and that she be give her the strength and the courage to do what she got to do. We lift her up in prayer. We know that you will heal her and remove whatever is in there, that you will heal her from head to toe. Also with Brother Raymond, if you can continue to be with Raymond and help him with whatever that has been ailing him. And we want to heal his body too. Also heal him from head to toe, from the inside to the outside, from the front, the back, the left, the right. All the way around, Lord, would you send your Holy Spirit upon them and descend the healing power of the Holy Spirit. And we claim this healing in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We thank you so much, Lord, for this beautiful day. We thank you for our service. We also thank you for the unanswered, the unspoken prayers that are speaking right now, Lord, that whatever is going on in each other's lives and in their hearts, that, Lord, we want to pray also that people take that first step, get out. Get off the bleachers, get on the field, and start doing what you have called us to do. And Lord, as you pour into us, let us continue to pour into others and not be afraid to go empty. Because we know, Lord, you are never fail us. You'll never leave us empty. You'll always continue to fill us up with your Holy Spirit. Let us share the gospel, the good news, because great is our reward in heaven. We thank you for our service this morning, and we give all our glory to you in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Imam Michael ho o Jehovah ki akua o kamakua aloha oe o kamahaku aloha o Yesu Kristo a me ka launa aloha olo anamai o ko uhani hemolele me ka ko pakahia pa. May the blessings of Jehovah God, the Father, the Lord of love, Jesus Christ, and the love of the Holy Spirit abide with us all. Now and forevermore. And everybody says, amen. Amen. You guys have a blessed day in the Lord. We love you guys. And we see you folks next week. Do me a favor. Smile. Let everybody know that you love Jesus and share his word. And you know what? Always walk expecting God's love. Amen. When you come, when you go, expect it. Something good is about to happen. Amen. We love you guys. God bless.
Lord, you are good and your mercy forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
day in the Lord, you guys. Aloha. God bless.
Eden is kingdom, and Eden mindset is a kingdom mindset. Let me hear ya. Where my Eden citizens at? Where my Eden